How's it going? My name is Scott Moss. I'm a founder at an AI startup, and I'm going to teach you how to get AI apps into production. I created this course because prototyping an app with an LLM or an agent is actually quite simple, but making it production ready is very difficult. In this course, we're going to learn how to improve our LLM and our agent by using evals and metrics, and then keeping things safe by introducing a human in a loop concept where an approval is needed to get something done, followed by managing the memory so we don't run out of tokens with our conversations in our agent. Go ship high quality AI agents that users love to use. Let's do one for generate image. So I'm going to say generate image.eval.ts. It's very similar, so I'm just going to copy it, bring it in here, paste it, import from generate image, select the DAD tool definition and change that to generate image tool definition. Going to give it a new experiment name. I'm going to call this generate image. Call it whatever you want. Cursor is already telling me that input's jacked. So I'm just going to go ahead and take that suggestion. And I'm going to say generate an image of a sunset. So I expect when a user says generate an image of a sunset for this to actually call the generate tool message. Now, we're not actually running the functions. We're just seeing if the AI is telling us to run the function, right? So let's try that one. So now I'm going to go here. I'm going to say generate image eval. And of course, I get 100 because I explicitly asked to do that. So, you know, you might get a user saying, you know, let's say you have some analytics and you like anonymized it so you can kind of see what people are saying, but you don't know who they are. And then you saw that someone said, you know, take a photo of the sunset. Would you expect that to generate an image? I don't know. It depends on what you want out of your app. If you want your app to be clever enough to know that taking a photo also means generating an image, then yeah, if you didn't think of that ahead of time, you would have had waited to a user to have said something like that. It would have had to fail. You would have had to collected it. And then you would have had to address it, right? So I actually don't know what that's going to do. So I don't know. If it fails, we'll address it. If it doesn't fail, let's see what happens. It did fail. So it doesn't think taking a photo is generating image, but I want my LLM to be that clever. So what do I do? How do I address this? How do I improve this? Because for some, like my LLM, my agent is like the number one users are photographers. So they always say, take a photo. So that's why that's happening. So those are my number one users. So I need to like, instead of telling them like, hey, stop saying take a photo, I need to make my LLM address take a photo.
How do you handle it when evaling things that aren't just like a Boolean, like call this tool or not? It could be like, is this structured output valid? Yep. These kinds of things.
We'll get into that right after this. There's so much of that. And you'll see why I had to do this first before I show you that. Because it's just a can of worms. It's just crazy. But we had to do this part first. So yeah, I have an LLM that is on a photography app and most of my users are photographers and they love to say take a photo when they actually mean generate something. So instead of telling them to say stop saying that, I should just tell my LLM to handle that, right? So how do I do that? Well, it failed, so I'm going to go here. I can put something in this description. Hey, taking a photo is the same thing as generating an image. Maybe I'll start with that, if I can spell photo right. There we go. I'll start with that description. I'll add that and let's see if that's good. So I'm gonna rerun this. And it did, it improved it. So now I feel pretty confident that if some user came in and said, take a photo, that it will call the generate image function. Hope you guys see the power of like just having evals in general, because if you didn't, there's no way you would ever. So not only do you need the evals, you need to like log what users are saying and you need to save that somewhere so you can do this part. Otherwise, there's literally no way you'll ever improve your system. It's like, how would you have known that this is what people were saying? It's so random. So like you have to be able to do that. But once you do, it's like, okay, you know, the first level of improvement is prompt engineering, and that's what we've been doing, but there's many levels of improvement. Prompt engineering is just like the first thing you do. So you'll see this a lot, HITL, that means human in the loop. You will see that a lot. Understanding human in the loop, basically, it's basically a safety mechanism, right? Like, this is how we prevent AIs from pressing the nuke button. We have to say yes before they press the nuke button. That's essentially what this is. By having a human in the loop, we prevent the AIs from doing destructive things. So what are destructive things? Anything that's not a query. If you think about CRUD, you know, the only thing that's non-destructive in CRUD is R, read. Everything else is destructive, creating, updating, and deleting. We don't want the AI creating anything, updating anything, or deleting anything without our approval. And I think from the bubble that I live in San Francisco, that is what everybody's moving towards too, of like, well, at first we thought AI was gonna automate everything and be really good. Now we're like, we don't wanna take the human element out of it. We don't wanna get rid of humans. We really want humans to be in here and have full control. We just want the AI to augment them. So it's like pro-human in the loop now. It's like, that's what everyone's doing. I wouldn't be surprised there's gonna be startups that only do this. So this is a thing. And the way that that surfaces from a UX pattern is mostly like an approval. Do you approve the AI of doing this thing? Yes or no, essentially. So it's something that we built into our system. I don't know. I'll take that back. I do know of other ways that people do it. I haven't seen people do it in other ways. I just know that they do it that way. And I'm not sure how many people do it the way that I'm going to be showing you today. But yeah, human in the loop is basically an approval system. So it's really cool because it protects you from a legal standpoint for creating AI. You know, we can come to you like, oh, your AI like just spent all my money. And it's like, well, you would have to have approved that because it doesn't do it unless you have an approval, just like a person wouldn't, right? It, you know, so you have that, but also, yeah, you know, it can save you money as well if things are just like a runaway AI. But also, yeah, safety mechanism to make sure, you know, imagine if you had an AI that had a tool that had delete access to your SQL production database. For some reason you made that, I don't know why. And then there was no approval. And then it hallucinated and somebody asked it to get ice cream, but it did that instead. Okay, you just dropped your whole database. So like having that approval is like pretty necessary, in my opinion. Cool, so several ways to implement human in a loop. So there's like the synchronous approval, which is what we're gonna be doing. So this is basically like, there is a direct pause in the execution. Nothing can go forward. The very next thing you do, the very next thing you say is gonna be considered a response to this approval. There's nothing else you can do. You're completely blocked. That's what we're gonna be doing. I think that's the simplest way. But typically the way that looks is agent decides to use a protected tool or not. We're actually not gonna do that. So we're not even gonna teach the agent what tool needs to be protected or not. We're just going to intervene ourselves deterministically because it's going to happen 100% of the time if we do it that way. If we try to teach the agent which tool needs to be protected through system prompts and tool descriptions, you got to eval that. It may or may not decide that this tool that you're trying to run needs an approval. And then it will still do things on accident and you still might need to manually intervene.
It's the protections of the approval. It has to decide if it should.
Exactly. If the AI has to decide if it needs an approval, what happens if it doesn't decide that? So, you know, but it's, I guess there's a benefit of the AI knowing that something, that it, there is this concept of approvals. So you might be able to do that. Like, hey, you know, there is this concept of approvals. You don't have to decide what the approvals are. Just letting you know, if you see a message saying, not approved from a tool call response, just know that like the user didn't approve that. So that way it knows and it can respond in a way where it's not confused. Because if you don't tell it that, and then you respond back from a tool call and you're saying it's not approved, they might be like, oops, couldn't do this. When in reality, it had no concept of an approval. If you told it there was an approval, it might be like, oh, sorry, I see you didn't approve that, my bad, right? So
just the maintaining the continuity of the conversation.
Exactly. Exactly. It's like, yeah, you got to loop this person in. Otherwise, you know what the hell's going on. It's literally like talking to a person. So now if we go back to the LLM, we need to do two things. We need to get the summary and put it in here, and then we need to create our summarized messages. So let's just start with our summarized messages, and then we can bring that back into here and keep it moving. So let's go to LLM. make a new function at the bottom called summarize messages. And this thing just is going to take in a list of messages. That's it. And then it's going to have a system prompt, and that's about it with those messages, and that's it. So let's say messages, AI message is that. Response is await. Run LLM. Gonna pass in those messages. Gonna pass in a system prompt. And we're gonna say your job is to summarize the given messages to be used in another LLM's system prompt. Summarize it, you know, play by play. So it's like, AI said this, user said this. AI said this, user said this. Otherwise, it'll like spit out a paragraph, which might also work. You got to play around with it. You have to eval this. So we got our messages. I'm a crank up the temperature a little bit on this. A little bit of randomness, I think. You know, why not? So then we just return the content. Just in case, fall back here. So we got that. And then while we're in here, we might as well go ahead and pull in the get summary. I want to do that up here. And the run LLM. So up here, I want to say get summary. And the system prompt is going to be this plus the summary. So I'll do this. And I can say conversation so far. Like that. And the last thing we need to do is go back to memory, go to where we're adding the messages, and summary right here should be await, summarize messages, and it's going to take in the oldest messages like that. Let's see what it does. What's my database looking like? Oh, we're looking good. We're looking good. Okay. Let's see if we broke something. Cool. I don't know. You tell me. Okay. Do it. Oh. Here's a joke for you. What do you call a beehive without the bees? An e-hive. Oh my goodness. That was so cringe. Humor can be quite subjective if you like. I can share a different type of joke. Yeah. Let's see. Do it. Let's see what this one says. Here's another joke for you. Why was the big cat disqualified from the race? Because it was a cheetah. Hope that one brings a smile. What a jerk. This thing is getting too good. Make me some art for that joke. Uh-oh. Yes, I do. Oh, I wonder if I put a check here. Check this out. Yeah. Wow. Putting a check emoji was an approval. That's actually pretty cool.
It's not ambiguous.
Yeah, so let's see what art it made. Come on. There we go. Come on. Come here. Oh my goodness. Why does that take so long? Oh Why is he so sad? Why is everybody
disqualified? He's a cheetah.
He's a cheetah. Oh my goodness. This is hilarious.